original Legs 11 that drove two fat ladies wild. It's Vernon Kay!
Welcome to All-Star Family Fortunes, the show where we ask, thank you very much, where we ask 100 people a range of everyday questions. Now, this week, I've been on the street and I found 100 drag queens. I asked them, do you have a little something tucked away for when you retire? Most of them said yes! The aim of the game is very simple. Two families of famous and some not-so-famous folk have to guess the top answers to the surveys we've carried out. Get them right and they could win up to £30,000 for a charity of their choice! How good's that? We'll get them wrong and they'll hear this. We've got two families tonight who don't know the meaning of the word defeat. In fact, to be honest with you, there are quite a few words that they don't know the meaning of. However, are you ready to meet them? Let's see if you can guess who's the ringleader of this rabble.
Hi, I'm his mum, Kathy.
And I'm his auntie, Max.
I always knew he was going to make it big.
We started off here in the streets of Bolton at 11, busking.
It's all about you.
Don't give up your day jobs, girls.
What?
He's a massive Bruce Springsteen fan. He's even named his pet dog after him.
And he's best known for being part of McFly, who sometimes get their kit off on stage.
Yeah!
He's had 7 number one hits,
and we're all chasing that top spot with him tonight. Yeah.
Flying into the studio with his family, it's Danny Jones! Hello, sir. Hi, Danny.
Hello.
Very good, pal, you?
Really good, thank you, yeah. Really
good, good looking, great hair, hordes of screaming women. Enough about me, how are you?
Really good, thank you.
Now, Danny, where have you brought your family from?
All the way from Bolton and Accrington.
Never mind. Danny, please introduce me to your family.
This is my mother, Kathy.
Hiya, Vernon.
My sister, Vicky.
Hi, Vicky.
Hi, Vernon.
She really has got 5 colours in her hair.
She has. Oh, terrible.
Can't resist it. Hey, there's more to come.
My auntie, Margaret.
Hi, Margaret.
Hi, Ben.
And my cousin, Paul.
You all right?
Not too bad.
Danny, which charity are you playing for tonight?
It's called When You Wish Upon a Star and it makes dreams come true for 6 children.
A great charity, Danny. Yeah. Good luck tonight. Yeah. Danny Jones! And, of course, the Jones family. Now, you need 2 families to play Family Fortune. Shall we roll out the next set of relatives? Yeah. Let's see if you can find out who's the queen bee of this celebrity swarm.
Hi, I'm Paul, her dad. She's a big football fan and still supports her childhood team, Huddersfield Town.
Sorry.
She's always loved acting, so she jumped at the chance to play money-loving Manny to Tanny Turner on Footballers' Wives. Wow, 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 wow.
She went from wag to lag when she was put behind bars in Bad Girls. I'm innocent!
Well, that's all the clues you're going to get. With some luck, you've guessed who it is. Bye!
Now, hoping to make her family fortunes, it's the one, the only, the sensational Zoe Locker!
Hi,
Zoe.
Hi, Vernon.
Lovely to see you. Welcome to Family Fortune.
Thank you.
Now, first things first, your character, Tanya, in Footballer's Wife, she was very similar to Fabio Capello, the England manager.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she could manage 11 men in 90 minutes as well.
Where have you brought your family from?
From Yorkshire.
All right. To the side of the Royals, Daniel. To the side of the Bennines. Zoe, please introduce you to your family.
OK, this is my dad, Paul.
Hi, Paul.
Hi, Vernon.
My brother, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, Vernon.
My sister, Susie.
Hi, Susie.
Hi, Vernon. And my older brother, Richard.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, Vernon.
Now, Zoe, what charity are you playing for tonight?
It's the Forget Me Not Trust, which is hoping to build a hospice for children.
Good luck tonight. Give a big round of applause. The Looker family. It's going to be the mother, father, brother and sister of all battles. Danny and Zoe, come and join me as we play Family Fortunes. Danny, of course, Zoe, Danny, one hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Good luck to both of you. It's single money, which means every point is worth a pound. We surveyed 100 people. We're looking for the top six answers. Name an item of clothing that people often lose. Danny from McFly.
Coat.
A coat. From experience?
No, I've never lost a coat.
It's going to be a long night, ladies. You're saying a coat, our survey says... coat! It took there, Zoe, but it's not the most popular answer. If you can find a more popular answer, then you'll take control of the board. What do you think?
Scarf?
Let's have a look. Scarf. Our survey says... oh, it's there, but it's not more popular than coat. Do you want to play or pass, Daniel?
Play.
We're going to play. Okay. All right, so we go back to your family. Start confirming. You might get a chance to steal. Hi, Kathy. How are you tonight?
I'm fine, thanks, Vernon.
Kathy, what do you think? An item of clothing that people often lose.
Hat.
OK, from experience? Left your wedding out anywhere?
Yeah, many times.
All right, good girl. You're saying a hat? Our survey says... yes, it's there. Well done, Kathy. Well done. Vicky.
Socks.
Socks.
Yeah.
You're saying socks? Our survey says... yes! Well done, Vicky. Second most popular answer. We're in good shape, Mags. We've got all three lives intact. We're looking for two more answers. What do you think, Mags?
Gloves.
All right, fair enough. Unless it's winter time and you've got that string that runs through your back. You're saying gloves. Our survey says... yes! Well done, Mags. More popular answer. Now then, Paul, it's all up to you. Now, let's see if we can have a clean sweep, a full board without losing any lives.
I'm going to guess slippers.
Slippers?
Yeah.
How many times have you got in your slippers and leave them somewhere? Surely they can only be under the sofa or in the dog.
We'll see.
All saying slippers. Our survey says... it's not there. What a surprise. I think you better go back to the green room and get your brain. All right, Danny, what do you think?
I reckon it's got to be trousers, ain't it?
You're saying trousers. Our survey says... oh, it's not! Don't give too much away. Millions of people watch this show. Kathy, what do you think? We're looking for one more answer. You've got one life left. Lookers, get ready. We could be coming over there. You might get the chance to steal.
Undies.
Where you get it from? You're saying your underpants. Our survey says... well, yeah! Well done, Kathy. Absolutely brilliant. Hey, well done, Danny. Full board. That's good. Danny. That very rarely happens on Family Fortunes, but well done. Give me one more big round of applause. At the end of the first round, the Lookers have yet to score. Yeah. Never mind. But in the lead with 89, it's the Joneses. Yeah. So, will the Lookers be able to keep up with the Joneses? Join us after the break for more Family Fortunes. Family Fortunes, it's the Joneses versus the Looker family. But will it be the pop star used to topping the charts or the actress used to topping her husbands? So, thank you very much. So far, the Lookers have yet to score, but in the lead with 89, it's the Joneses. Very popular contestant is our Danny boy. All right, Kathy and Paul, it's time to defend the family honour. Come and join me. Let's continue playing Family Fortunes. Paul, this is Kathy. Kathy, this is Paul. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. All right, here goes. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top 6 answers. Name an animal that might eat you. Paul, very quick.
Crocodile.
A crocodile. Yes, well done. That's one of the audience tonight. You're saying a crocodile. Let's have a look how the survey says. Yay! Yeah, it's there, but it's only the 4th most popular answer. Kathy, can you find a more popular answer than crocodile?
A lion.
A lion? Yeah. You're saying a lion. Let's have a look how the survey says. Yeah! Well done. Kathy, do you want to play or pass?
Hey.
All right, you're going to play. Fair enough. Paul, go back to your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal. Now, Vicky. How long has your brother been playing guitar?
Since he was 6.
Do you play any instruments?
I don't, no.
No? All right, well, we've got some great footage now, Daniel. McFly fans, you're going to love this. This is a wonderful clip of Danny and his beautiful sister getting together as a duo one lovely Christmas time at the Jones family house. Take a look.
Oh, of course.
I think you were positioned there. Come here, Vicky. Come here, Vicky. I think you were positioned there, right? No, just wait there. I've got a couple of instruments for you. I think you were playing the blue tennis racket and you were playing the guitar. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a special treat for you now with the music. Danny and Vicky George recreating what they did millions of years ago. Take it away. Well done. You have the moves, then, at such a young age.
Sure.
Right, then, let's crack on. Vicky, your turn. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Here we go. Name an animal that might eat you.
A shark.
A shark. Good answer. You're saying a shark? Our survey says? Yes, second most popular. Mags, what do you think?
A tiger.
You're saying a tiger? Our survey says? Yes, well done. Once again, we've got all 3 lives in sight. We're looking for 2 more missing answers. Paul, what do you think?
I'm going to guess burr.
Sorry?
Burr.
A what?
A bird. Who's the bird?
how are you spelling that?
B-E-A-R.
All right, OK. Nice.
Burr.
A burr. Right, you're saying a burr. Our survey says... Yeah! Well done, Paul. Right, Danny. Can you do this without losing a life?
Well...
the last answer to find.
Yeah, I saw a picture of this, actually. A snake.
Yes.
Right.
Basically had a man inside it, so...
Let's have a look. You're saying...
Snake.
A snake. Our survey says... To you. Looking for one more answer. You've got 2 lives left. Come on, Kathy.
Gorilla? I don't know.
Step away from the answer. Right. Here we go.
Gorilla.
Kathy, you're saying gorilla. A gorilla. Our survey says... It's not there. Oh, what a surprise. Vicky.
A wolf.
I'll tell you what, Vicky, if the answer's up there, I'm going to ring up Les Dennis and get him to give you the money himself.
I can't think of anything else.
Survey. So. Oh, it's not there! Right, Richard, what do you think?
Piranha.
Piranha. Susie?
Piranha.
Piranha. Steve?
I think piranha too.
Right, Paul?
Me as well, if you haven't seen anyone left.
Need an answer?
Piranha.
You're going to go piranha. If it's up there, you've stolen from the Jones family. If it's not, you guys have won the point. Let's have a look. You're saying piranha. Our survey says... it's not! Well done, Danny. Yeah. Well done, the Jones family. Congratulations. Unlucky luckers. Unlucky luckers. Right, let's take a look at that missing answer. Sixth most popular answer was... You're having a laugh. You're having an absolute laugh. So, at the end of round two, the lookers have still yet to score. Come on! But in the lead with 186, it's the Jones family! Right, it's time to crank up the pressure. This is where the looker family can get back in the game. It's time to double the dosh. Vicky and Steve, come and join me as we play Double Money. Vicky, Steve, Vicky. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Good. Here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
It's double money, which means every point is worth twice the price. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top five answers. Name something people put in their mouths every day. Vicky.
Toothbrush.
A toothbrush. Well done. Sensible answer. You're saying a toothbrush. Our survey says... yes, well done. It's only the second most popular answer, though. Steve, if you can get that top answer, you take control of the board, and hopefully we'll get some points on the board. What do you think?
Food.
Food! You're saying food, our survey says... yeah! So play off that. We're going to play. All right, Vicky, go back, join your family. Yeah, you too, Steve. Well done. Susie, what do you think?
Water.
Our survey says... it's not there, Susie. You're unlucky. Richard, what do you think?
A fork.
You're saying fork? Our survey says... yes! Yes! Yes, Richard! Well done, my friend! Congratulations, Richard! You know what that noise means on Family Fortunes? It means you've won a spot prize. Congratulations, Richard. Take a look at this. It's coming home with you tonight.
Don't just sit there, Richard. Do it yourself. You've just nailed an entire range of Black & Decker home improvement tools. Work it, baby.
Is that something you're good at?
Not good, but it'll come in useful.
Zoe, name something that people put in their mouths every day. Think in the mind of Zoe Looker, not Tanya.
Toothpaste.
Let's have a look. So we're saying toothpaste. Our survey says... it's not the unlucky. Get ready, Jones family. You might be over there. You might get a chance to steal. Paul, what do you think?
I would say drink.
You're saying drink. Our survey says... it's not the unlucky. What do you think? Paul?
I'm going to say a cigarette.
Cigarette, Max?
A glass.
A glass, Vicky?
Fingers.
Cup glass.
Cup glass, Danny. You can have one of them or one of your own. Mm. What are you going to go for?
We'll go for a cup.
If it's up there, you've won the board. If it's not, Zoe and the Looker family, you have won the point. Let's have a look. All right, you're saying cup for the steal. Our survey says... it's not there! Well done, Zoe. Well done. We've got some points on the board.
I'm rubbish at
this. Absolutely useless.
Yeah, but you didn't say gorilla or wolf.
No, I nearly did.
Right, let's take a look at those two remaining answers. The fifth most popular answer was... false teeth! Of course, of course. And the fourth most popular was... a foot!
Oh, I said that.
At the end of the first double money round, the scores are the lookers have 146, but in the lead just with 186, it's the Jones family! Let's continue with our four family members. Mags and Susie, come and join me for the final round of double money. Come in, Mags. There you go, Susie. Well done. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your backs. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top four answers. Name a famous superhero. Susie.
Superman.
Superman. Popular. And the survey says... yes, well done. You want to play our fast, Susie?
Play.
You want to play? All right, Mags, go back, join your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal again. Name a famous superhero. Richard.
Spider-Man.
Let's have a look. Our survey says... yeah, well done. Yeah, second more popular. Really good stead at the moment. You've got all three lives intact. We only need two more answers. So, come on. Good luck, Zoe. What do you think?
Batman.
Batman. Yeah, well done. What does Batman have at 5 o'clock every day?
I don't know, Vernon.
His dinner, 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 Batman! All the way from the schoolyard, 1983. All right. You're saying?
Batman.
Our survey says... It's there! Paul, pressure's on you now. If you get this next question right, you've won the main game and we're going to go forward and play big money. All right, Paul, what do you think?
Iron Man!
Come on. Come on, Iron Man.
Sorry, I'm taking this too seriously.
No, we like it. We like it, Paul. Say it one more time with gusto.
Iron Man.
You're saying
Iron Man.
Our survey says... No, it's not there! Right, Steve, come on. Get ready, Jones family. Get ready, Steve. Pressure's on. We need one more answer. You've got two lives left.
Hulk.
You're saying Hulk, the Incredible Hulk.
Yeah. Yeah.
Our survey says... Oh, it's not there! The pressure's on you now, Susie.
Again?
Get ready, Jones family.
Wonder Woman?
All right. Yeah, break them all. We've had three blocks. Could be a last. You never know. You're saying... Wonder Woman, to take your family due to big money, our survey says... It's not there! It's not there, Paul. What do you think?
Catwoman.
Catwoman. Mags?
I forgot what I was going
to say. Nothing there. Vicky, what do you think?
Robin.
Robin. Kathy. Robin. Danny.
Robin, I reckon.
All right. For the steal from the lookers to go through to big money, you're saying Robin... As a famous superhero, our survey says... No! It's not there! Well done. Well done. Congratulations. Look, if I'm next. Let's have a look. Right, that missing answer. Superman. Spider-Man. Batman. Amazing! Super Ted! Super Ted! You had a sidekick called Spot! Congratulations, the Looker family. You will be playing big money. Commiserations, the Jones family. Unlucky.
Thank you, mate.
Have you enjoyed yourselves?
Yeah, I've had a really good time. Thanks for having me. Thanks.
Good stuff. Well, you've won 186 points. We're going to times that by 10, which means you're going to walk away with 1,860 pounds. For the charity of your choice. Now, just remind us what your charity was.
When you wish upon a star.
Danny, thank you very much for coming. Give a big round of applause to the Jones family. That's family fortune, Zoe. Now, Zoe, the pressure is on you now. You and a family member are going to go down the front, and a little later on, we're going to play big money. Who are you going to play with?
My brother Steve.
All right, Steve, Zoe, come and join me. Let's play big money. Find out if the Looker family can win that big money prize after the break. Hey, welcome back. Now, before the break, we saw the Looker family romp home and win the main game, which means it's now their chance to win that cool £30,000. Now, Zoe's backstage. You can't see or hear us, so let's play big money. Right, good luck, Steve. Between you and Zoe, you need to get 200 points. If you do that, we'll give you £10,000. However, if you get all five top answers, we'll give you 30 grand for your chosen charity tonight. Cool. I'm going to ask you five questions. You've got 15 seconds. If you can't think of an answer, just say pass, and we'll come to it. If we've got time, at the end.
Okay.
Your time starts when I finish the first question. Do you understand the rules?
Sure do, yeah.
Good luck, Steve. Can I have 15 seconds on the clock, please? Name something that most people have in the boot of their car.
A car jack.
Name something people can be allergic to.
Horses.
Name a living creature that does not have legs.
Snake.
Name one of Winnie the Pooh's friends.
Tigger.
Name something that can be mint flavoured.
Toothpaste.
Well done, Justin. No, well done, Steve. Well done. You did the hardest thing, and that's get all the answers in 15 seconds. Well done. All right, let's turn around, Steve. Let's see how you've done. Fingers crossed. Here we go, Steve. Name something that most people have in the boot of their car. You said a jack. Our survey said 16. Well done, good start. It would be nice if we could get 100 points. Make it 50-50.
Yeah.
When Zoe comes
on. Pressure on for Zoe.
Name something people can be allergic to. You said nay. Horses. Our survey said 17. Well done. Are you allergic to horses?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Name a living creature that does not have legs. You said snake. Our survey said 26. Well done, man. Good scoring. We just edge up to 100 with these last two answers. Zoe will be in good stead. Name one of Winnie the Pooh's friends. You said T-R-G-G-R. Tigger. Our survey said 33. Well done. Got 92. Name something that can be mint flavoured. You said toothpaste. Our survey said 24. Well done. Great score. Well done, Steve. Congratulations. That's a good score on the 16. Go back, join your family. Let's clear the board and let's welcome back Zoe Lucker. Steve did really, really well.
Oh, good.
He got 116.
Oh, good.
Right, which means you need 84 for £10,000. Remember, if we get all five top answers, we'll give you 30 grand. Right, good luck, Zoe. I'm going to ask you the same five questions, but because it's a little bit more difficult, I'm going to give you an extra 5 seconds. Okay. You got 20 seconds. Time starts when I finish the first question. If you can't think of an answer, just say pass, and we'll come to it if we've got time at the end. If you give me an answer that Steve's already given me, you'll hear this noise. I'll ask you for another answer.
OK.
Right, good luck, Zoe.
Thank you.
Deep breath. Can have 20 seconds on the clock and can remind viewers at home of Steve's answers. Name something that most people have in the boot of their car.
Blanket.
Name something people can be allergic to.
Hay fever.
Name a living creature that does not have legs.
Snail.
Name one of Winnie the Pooh's friends.
Tigger.
Another answer.
Pass.
Name something that can be mint flavoured.
Chewing gum.
Name one of Winnie the Pooh's friends. All right, well done. Well done, some good answers there. Don't be disarmed.
I don't know Winnie the Pooh yet.
You don't know Winnie the Pooh?
No.
Oh, you will, trust me.
I know.
All right, let's take a look at Steve's answers, please. All right, good luck, Zoe. As you can see, he scored 116, which means you need 84 for £10,000. Remember, we're still looking for top five answers. And if you get all top five answers, we'll give you 30 grand. Good luck. Name something that most people have in the boot of their car. You said a blanket if you're over 53. Our survey said 10.
Oh.
Well done. Got 126. Now, is Jack a top answer? No, it's not. I can tell you the top answer was worth 45 points and it was spare wheel.
Oh, I can't
so we're looking try. For 10 grand now, right? We've got 126. Name something people can be allergic to. You said hay fever. Our survey said it's not there.
It's not.
I can tell you that nuts was a top answer worth 30 points. Name a living creature that does not have legs. You said a snail. Our survey said 8. 134. Well done. I can tell you that snake was the top answer. Well done, Steve. Name one of Winnie the Pooh's friends. You said pass. We didn't have time when we went back to it. So you get one of these. But I can tell you that Tigger was the top answer. Now, this final question has to be worth 66 or more for £10,000 for your charity. Good luck, Zoe. Name something that can be mint-flavoured. You said chewing gum, 66 or more. Our survey said 26. Unlucky. Look, the family, come and join me. I can tell you chewing gum was the top answer. Give them a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Unlucky, Steve. Unlucky, Zoe. Unlucky. Unfortunately, you don't win one of the big cash prizes, but have you enjoyed yourself?
Yes, yeah. Very much so.
Good.
Thank
and Richard, you walk away with that DIY set. You scored 160 points in that round. We're going to add that to the total from earlier on. We're going to times it by 10, which means tonight for your charity, Zoe, you've won £4,900. Well done.
Thank you. Thank you.
Just remind us what your charity was.
Forget Me Not Trust, trying to build a hospice for children.
Well, well done, Zoe. One more round of applause. The Looker family. Thank you to both our families. Join us next time when we play more Family Fortunes. Good night.
That drove two fat ladies wild. It's Fern and Kay.
Hello and welcome to All Star Family Fortunes, the show where we ask, thank you very much, where we ask 100 people a range of everyday questions. Now, this week I've been on the street and I found 100 drag queens. I asked them, do you have a little something tucked away for when you retire? Most of them said yes! The aim of the game is very simple. Two families of famous and some not-so-famous folk have to guess the top answers to the surveys we've carried out. Get them right and they could win up to £30,000 for a charity of their choice! How good's that? We'll get them wrong and they'll hear this. We've got two families tonight who don't know the meaning of the word defeat. In fact, to be honest with you, there are quite a few words that they don't know the meaning of. However, are you ready to meet them? Let's see if you can guess who's the ringleader of this rabble.
Hi, I'm his mum, Kathy.
And I'm his auntie, Meg.
I always knew he was going to make it big.
We started off here in the streets of Bolton at 11, busking.
It's all about you.
Don't give up your day jobs, girls.
What?
He's a massive Bruce Springsteen fan. He's even named his pet dog after him.
And he's best known for being part of McFly, who sometimes get their kit off on stage.
Yeah!
Yeah. He's had 7 number one hits.
And we're all chasing that top spot with him tonight. Yeah.
Yeah. Here, McFlying into the studio with his family, it's Danny Jones! Very good, pal, you?
Really good, thank you, yeah. Really
good, good looking, great hair, hordes of screaming women. Enough about me, how are you?
Really good, thank you.
Now, Danny, where have you brought your family from?
All the way from Bolton and Accrington.
Never mind. Danny, please introduce me to your family.
This is my mother, Kathy.
Hiya, Vernon.
My sister, Vicky.
Hi, Vicky.
Hi, Vernon.
She really has got 5 colours in her hair.
She has. Oh, terrible.
Can't resist terrible. It. Hey, there's more to come.
My auntie Margaret.
Hi, Matt.
Evan.
And my cousin Paul.
You all right?
Not too bad.
Danny, which charity are you playing for tonight?
It's called When You Wish Upon a Star and it makes dreams come true for 6 children.
A great charity, Danny. Good luck tonight. There you go. And, of course, the Jones family. Now, you need 2 families to play Family Fortune. Shall we roll out the next set of relatives? Yeah! Let's see if you can find out who's the queen bee of this celebrity swarm.
Hi, I'm Paul, her dad. She's a big football fan and still supports her childhood team, Huddersfield Town.
Sorry.
She's always loved acting, so she jumped at the chance to play money-loving man-eater Tanya Turner on Footballers' Wives. Wow, 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 wow.
She went from wag to lag when she was put behind bars in Bad Girls.
I'm innocent! Well, that's all the clues you're going to get. With some luck, you guessed who it is. Bye!
Now, hoping to make her family fortunes, it's the one, the only, the sensational Zoe Lucker! Hi, Zoe.
Hi, Vernon.
Lovely to see you. Welcome to Family Fortunes.
Thank you.
Now, first things first, your character, Tanya, in Footballers' Wives, she was very similar to Fabio Capello, the England manager.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she could manage 11 men in 90 minutes as well. Where have you brought your family from?
From Yorkshire.
All right. To the side of the Moors, Daniel. To the side of the Bennines. Zoe, please introduce him to your family.
OK, this is my dad, Paul.
Hi, Paul.
Hi, Vernon.
My brother, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, Vernon.
My sister, Susie.
Hi, Susie.
Hi, Vernon. And my older brother, Richard.
Hi, Richard.
Hi, Vernon.
Now, Zoe, what charity are you playing for tonight?
It's the Forget Me Not Trust, which is hoping to build a hospice for children.
Good luck tonight. Give a big round of applause. The Lucker family. It's going to be the mother, father, brother and sister of all battles. Danny and Zoe, come and join me as we play Family Fortunes. Danny, of course, Zoe, Danny, one hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Good luck to both of you. It's single money, which means every point is worth a pound. We surveyed 100 people. We're looking for the top six answers. Name an item of clothing that people often lose. Danny from McFly.
Coat.
A coat. From experience?
No, I've never lost a coat.
It's going to be a long night, ladies. You're saying a coat, our survey says... Coat! It's up there, Zoe, but it's not the most popular answer. If you can find a more popular answer, then you'll take control of the board. What do you think?
Scarf?
Let's have a look. Scarf, our survey says... Oh, it's there, but it's not more popular than coat. Do you want to play or pass, Daniel?
Play.
We're going to play. Okay. All right, Zoe, go back to your family. Start conferring, you might get a chance to steal. Hi, Catherine. How are you tonight?
I'm fine, thanks, Vernon.
Kathy, what do you think? An item of clothing that people often lose?
Hat.
OK, from experience? Left your wedding out anywhere?
Yeah, many times.
All right, good girl. You're saying a hat? Our survey says... Yes, it's there. Well done, Kathy. Well done. Vicky.
Socks.
Socks. Yeah. You're saying socks? Our survey says... Yes! Well done, Vicky. Second most popular answer. We're in good shape, Mags. We've got all three lives intact. We're looking for two more answers. What do you think, Mags?
Gloves.
All right, fair enough. Unless it's winter time and you've got that string that runs through your back. You're saying gloves. Our survey says... Yeah! Well done, Mags. Most popular answer. Now then, Paul, it's all up to you. Now, let's see if we can have a clean sweep, a full board without losing any lives.
I'm going to guess slippers.
Slippers?
Yeah.
How many times have you got any slippers and leave them somewhere? Surely they can only be under the sofa or in the dog.
We'll see.
All same slippers. Our survey says... It's not there. What a surprise. I think you better go back to the green room and get your brain. All right, Danny, what do you think?
I reckon it's got to be trousers, hasn't it?
You're saying trousers. Our survey says... Oh, it's not! Don't give too much away. Millions of people watch this show. Kathy, what do you think? We're looking for one more answer. You've got one life left. Lookers, get ready. We could be coming over there. You might get the chance to steal.
Undies.
Where you get it from? You're saying your underpants. Our survey says... Well, yeah! Well done, Cathy. Absolutely brilliant. Hey, well done, Danny. Full board. That's good. That very rarely happens on Family Fortunes, but well done. Give me one more big round of applause. At the end of the first round, the Lookers have yet to score, never mind. But in the lead with 89, it's the Joneses. Yeah. So, will the Lookers be able to keep up with the Joneses? Join us after the break for more Family Fortunes. Family Fortunes, it's the Joneses versus the Looker family. But will it be the pop star used to topping the charts or the actress used to topping her husbands? So, thank you very much. So far, the Lookers have yet to score, but in the lead with 89, it's the Joneses. Very popular contestant is our Danny boy. All right, Cathy and Paul, it's time to defend the family honour. Come and join me. Let's continue playing Family Fortunes. Paul, this is Cathy. Cathy, this is Paul. One on by your buzzer, one on behind your back. All right, here goes. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top 6 answers. Name an animal that might eat you. Paul, very quick.
Crocodile.
A crocodile. Yes, well done. Top of the audience tonight. You're saying a crocodile. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Yay! Yeah, it's the one of the 4th most popular answer. Cathy, can you find a more popular answer than crocodile?
A lion.
A lion? We're saying a lion. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Yeah! Well done. Cathy, do you want to play or pass?
Hey.
All right, you're going to play. Fair enough. Paul, go back to your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal. Now, Vicky, how long has your brother been playing guitar?
Since he was 6.
Do you play any instruments?
I don't, know.
No? All right, well, we've got some great footage now, Daniel. McFly fans, you're going to love this. This is a wonderful clip of Danny and his beautiful sister getting together as a duo one lovely Christmas time at the Jones family house. Take a look.
Oh, my goodness.
I think you were positioned there. Come here, Vicky. Come here, Vicky. I think you were positioned there, right? No, just wait there. I've got a couple of instruments for you. I think you were playing the blue tennis racket and you were playing the guitar. All right.
Music.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a special treat for you now. With the music. Danny!